Electrical Course, Geophysical Engineering, Department Faculty of Mining and Petroleum Engineering, Bandung Institute of Technology. Our instructors is already in this room. There are Mr. Muhammad Arif Munandar and Ms. Rui Song, PhD student from Chiba University, Japan. So we are going to the first session. And first, I will share my screen. Okay, so today is day 5 and we are going to the first session. And the topic for today is affiliation turbulence on Indonesia and the relationship to Himawara 8 weather satellite imagery. And the first, we are going to talking about this topic with Mr. Muhammad Arif Munandar, PhD student from Chiba University, Japan. And I am Harmita Lestari as a moderator for today. First, Mr. Arif Munandar, how are you today?
Yeah, I'm good. Thank you, Ms. Harmita. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. And Ms. Rui Song, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Okay, how are you today? Okay, thank you. So, Mr. Muhammad Arif Munandar, you have about 45 minutes to deliver your presentations. And next, we will continue to the Ms. Rui Song to deliver her presentation about 45 minutes. And we will continue with a question and answer sessions. So, here also, Mr. Dr. Wahyudi Widiatmoko and Dr. Indra Gunawan, from a lecturer from Geophysical Engineering Department, Bandung Institute of Technology, as a committee for this IVC. So Mr. Arif Munandar, time is yours.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Harmita. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, a member of International Virtual Course, the Honorable Mr. Dr. Wahyudi Widiatmoko. Thank you very much the opportunity that give to me. In this afternoon, we will study together related with the aviation turbulence on Indonesia and the relationship to Himawari 8 weather satellite imagery. I will share my screen. Could you see my screen?
Yes, clearly.
Okay. Thank you very much. Okay, this is my short briefly about myself. My name is Muhammad Arif Munandar. I am a doctoral student on Environmental Remote Sensing, Chiba University, under supervision of Prof. Yos and Prof. Atsushi Higuchi. I live at Sepatan, Tangerang, and my last education from Institute Teknologi Bandung too, same with almost of the member on the Faculty of Earth Science. Now I working on agency for meteorology, climatology, and geophysics. On 2008 until 2015, I am an observer and forecaster on Hasanuddin Meteorological Station. And then from 2015 until now, I'm a senior officer at the Center for Aviation Meteorology. I have some of publication and my skill and expertise on meteorology and aviation meteorology. Okay. In this afternoon, briefly about the what is the aviation meteorology. Maybe I will start from the Indonesia. we know together that Indonesia is a archipelago nation that contain many island. Yeah, there are many island. As we know that more than 70,000 island, from the big island until a small island. On the other hand, Indonesia, a nation, have many population. Yeah, we know that over the world, Indonesia have a big five of the population, from the China, India, United States, and Indonesia and Brasilia. Between Indonesia have many island and have much population, the people need a transportation to connect between each island. So we need transportation. There are many type of transportation, from water transportation, air transportation, and land transportation. In this afternoon, we will focus on air transportation because with the air transportation, we can reach the destination with a fast time than another transportation, especially with the airplane. If we use airplane, we focus about the safety factor, because with the safety, we can arrive at the destination safely. Yeah, there are some factor that affect of the safety on aviation. The first is about the airplane itself. It's related with the body of the airplane, the machine of the airplane. Related with the airplane, there are any technician on the airport that they make sure about the good of or bad about the airplane. So if the good airplane, we can use it, and if the bad, they will repair it. Yeah, maybe you know. The second is about the airline or the pilot. Yeah, we know who is the pilot. Yeah. Yeah, this is Captain Vincent. Yeah, it's a very famous on YouTube. Yeah, so the pilot is the second factor that affect the safety on aviation, because the pilot can manage, about the aircraft or the airplane, and they can maneuver or they can do anything that make a passenger safety. And then about the third, about the airport facility. Yeah, in this picture, we can see there are any LAMP. Yeah, the LAMP is about the instrument landing system that can help the airplane to precision to land to the runway. And the other facility related with how the airplane can use it for takeoff and landing. And the last is about the weather. Yeah. Weather is atmospheric condition, yeah, that can impact on aeroplane. Related with our position, Indonesia, the weather on Indonesia, because on tropical area, there are we have two season. The development of the cloud is very high. So we must aware about the weather related with the aeroplane. Okay, this is the flight stage of the airplane. Yeah, I read here all stage of the flight need weather information. From we know from the flight plane, pushback or taxi, takeoff, cruise and descent, final approach and landing. Yeah, maybe we are passenger, we don't know about the process. We just sit. And from the departure until to destination, yeah. But in the big at the background, yeah, the airlines use weather information to plan our journey. Like the example, if you from the Jakarta to Surabaya, the airline calculate how many fuel that the flight can bring, and if on Surabaya, there are bad weather, the airplane will be go to another place. Or if there are any volcanic activity, the airplane maybe must return to Jakarta again. So weather is very important for the flight plan. And for the taxi, yeah, if you use an airplane on the Soekarno-Hatta before the COVID, maybe you feel about the many airplane waiting, yeah, because there are limited runway, so they use only one runway to take off. And yeah, because weather is a need for the where the airplane can use for takeoff and landing. Yeah, because airplane need headwind to take off. And on the cruise stage, yeah, sometimes we feel turbulence. Yeah, we will turbulence when the flight attendant share about the food, or yeah, we enjoy about the flight. We see the condition from the window. Yeah, sometimes we feel the turbulence. And then for final approach and landing, yeah, the pilot need see about the runway clearly before land, because if the pilot cannot see clearly the runway, the pilot not land at the destination airport, because it's very dangerous if the pilot cannot see about the runway. Yeah, so the weather information is very important. So what is the purpose of the weather service for aviation from the International Civil Aviation Organization? There are three purposes of weather service for aviation. The first is about the safety that I said before, that all of the states is a need of the weather information. And the second is related with the efficiency. Yeah, from the picture, in the left of the picture, we can see that the white the white line is the force route. Yeah, but the pilot see about the cloud. Yeah, from the theory, the pilot avoid to across the cloud, so the pilot must maneuver here to avoid the cloud. So the airplane have the efficiency to avoid the cloud. And the third about the regularity. Yeah, especially the regularity is for the crowded airport like Soekarno-Hatta. Yeah, with the good weather service or weather information, the regularity is good, especially for the airline and for the passenger. Yeah, there are many weather phenomena that impact aviation. The first, about the cloud, there are many type of the cloud, like high cloud, middle cloud, and low cloud. And there are many type from the cirrus until stratus or satocumulus. And this is the dangerous cloud, cumulus or cumulonimbus, yeah. We know that cumulonimbus cloud can make a thunderstorm and can make a wind shear and can make turbulence. And the other weather is a fog or smoke. Why? Because the pilot must see or must have a good visibility in front of the cloud, in front of the airplane. Because in some accident, the pilot cannot see the object in front of the airplane. And then snow. Yeah, snow is is a weather that impact, because snow can impact the runway, so the airplane cannot take off and land. And the icing. Icing is the important weather for the airplane, because the icing can disturb about the body of the airplane and about the engine. So the body of the airplane is not stable and make the airplane is weaker than before. And next about the volcanic ash. Yeah, in Indonesia, there are many volcano. So the volcanic ash is very dangerous. for the body of the airplane and for the machine. So if there are airport that have a volcanic ash, the airport will close and the turbulence. Yeah, we will focus on these turbulence. Where we get the information about the meteorological information, in Indonesia, you can access the www.aviation.bmkg.go.id. You can get, there are many information, like the warning information, observation information, forecast information, and other information. There are any significant meteorology, volcanic ash, weather and visibility, and this is observation, real observation, and then satellite image, and then forecast of the aviation. Okay. Related with the turbulence, we can get the information of the turbulence from the significant weather chart. The chart of or the picture here is produced by World Area Forecast Center from London that we can see. Yeah, this is the symbol of the turbulence. You can see the CAT area. CAT is clear air turbulent area. Yeah, the this is the number one until number six. So if you will fly from the Jakarta here to Surabaya, there are no turbulence. But it's very maybe it's very dangerous if because there are some turbulence maybe or the another weather like here. Yeah, you can see there are Konson, yeah, the tropical cyclone Konson and Cantu. There are tropical cyclone here near the Filipina. So if you will go to the Japan, yeah, from the Jakarta to Japan, yeah, you will pass the tropical cyclone. Nah, yeah, and yeah, there are no turbulent information here. Yeah, this is the turbulent information like here. Yeah, number four, and this is number two, and number six, and where is number one? Yeah, in this picture, the turbulent information related with here. This is the name of the jet stream. Jet stream is the region that have speed more than 50 knots. Yeah. More than 50 knots, so it's very dangerous. It's dangerous for the airplane that because they can produce the clear air turbulent area. Okay, yeah. What is the atmospheric turbulence? Yeah, this is the definition of the atmospheric turbulence. Atmospheric turbulence is a random movement in the atmosphere. Yeah, yeah. If we use the airplane and the route of the flight. Overlay with the location of the atmospheric turbulence, so we can call it the aviation turbulence. Yeah. What make the aviation turbulence? Yeah. There are some type of the turbulence. The first is, like I said before, there are any clear air turbulence. Yeah. Clear air turbulence make from the jet stream. This is a phenomena from the wind speed, the region of the wind speed more than 50 knots. And then related with the mountain, we can say about the mountain wave turbulence. Yeah, because the breaking wave of the mountain wave. And then if the turbulence near the convective, the name is convective induced turbulence. So the first is clear air turbulence, the second is mountain wave turbulence, and the third about the convective turbulence. And the fourth related with the airplane itself. Some people say about the wave vortex turbulence and make from the wingspan of the Hugh or the white airplane. Yeah. This is the effect of the turbulence. Yeah, I get for the Sarman and Lane. the first picture is related with the damage, yeah, mountain wave turbulence. Yeah, this is a military aircraft. At that time, the information of the turbulence is very limited. So they get the safer mountain wave turbulence and make the body is broken. And you can see there are no tail, but yeah, I don't know how the airplane can fly with no tail. And in B image, that the machine, yeah, the machine, yeah, the machine separate from the wing, yeah, because the extreme turbulence. And you can see in the C is about the elevator, yeah, is broken because turbulence in cloud. And the picture about the related with the effect, cabin broken because the passenger, yeah. In airplane we must use buckle to avoid the turbulence. Here about what is the source of the aviation turbulence? There are some source. I have a picture from the, this is airplane. They will feel the turbulence. Yeah, and they say there are any turbulence, and if they will report to the nearest tower, and they say they feel turbulence. The name, the information is IRAP, I report. Yeah, so the pilot requests to descend because if the airplane feel the turbulence, they will up or down to minimize the effect of the turbulence. The name is IRAP. And the other source is about from the research aircraft. Yeah, this is a special aircraft that used to get the information related with the phenomena, weather phenomena. For the turbulence, the aircraft is entered to the region of the turbulence. The aircraft will measure about the intensity or about the effect of the turbulence, about the variable of the atmosphere, where the turbulence happen. And we can use the, yeah, you know, it's a black box. Yeah, the black box, the color is not black, but the orange. Yeah, from the black box, we can see about the information. Yeah, like the gas, like the gravity, or like the engine speed, and yeah, and all of the information from the aircraft. So we can analyze from this black box. And yeah, we can use another technology like a satellite. Yeah, satellite can detect the object like here. They detect the cloud that can make turbulence. This is from the outside of the Earth and from the ground. Yeah, we can use a radar. Weather radar can detect about the cloud. How about the characteristic of the cloud? What is the type of the cloud that can make turbulence? And the last is about the weather forecast model. Yeah, we use the weather forecast model because in some location there are limitation of the data. So we can use the weather forecast model to identify or to forecast about the information related with the turbulence. Yeah, this is the sample of the one of the source of the aviation turbulence. I get it from the Angkasa Pura 1. Yeah, is 7 September 2011. Yeah, at the time I on duty. So I get this information. From traffic service duty manager, because they will write everything that happened related with the airplane. Yeah, we can see here that SEA is the registration of the flight. This is Singapore Airlines. This is the origin and to destination to Singapore on flag level 40,000 feet. Yeah, in KFOG, yeah, they request this change because they're turbulent. And then after that, there are any turbulent too, the same position, but same position and some flag level. Due to turbulence 2, and here this is the same. So the information the air traffic control get from the pilot and the air traffic control write the information and they inform to meteo or to agency for meteorology and climatology and GPSH. We will know where is KFOG. Yeah, where is KFOG? Because it's not familiar position. In aviation, we have a special chart. Like if we use a motorcycle or car on the ground, we use route. Yeah, same with that. On the air, the airplane use a route too. The name is route of domestic route or international route. And with the route, there are any reporting point. Yeah, like here from the previous report that the airplane feel the turbulence near the KFOG. Yeah, this is a location of the KFOG, and the red circle is the location that turbulence happen. So there are many reporting point on the air, and the pilot must be reported if they feel something. You can get the chart from the AIRNAV. No, is the name of the AIRNAV. AIRNAV Indonesia is the air traffic service provider. Before that, the AIRNAV is Angkasa Pura. Okay. This is the turbulence distribution from the report. There are sums of the location of the turbulence, and from this turbulence, we can see that the turbulence location, most of the turbulence happen over the sea. And then I try use a model of the atmospheric model to know how about the turbulence happen with the number of the Richardson. This is the different time, and we can see that the yellow is the lowest number of the Richardson. So in the concept that the Richardson number less than one the turbulence will happen, and then it's all right at this event. And another source is we can use air traffic control strip. This is a strip, or this is the tool that the air traffic control use, but it's very limited. It's very limited that you can get it. Maybe you can visit it the tower, AirNav and you can see it. Yeah, what is the air traffic control strip? Yeah, this is aircraft type. I'm sorry, it's an airline code, and this is aircraft type. Yeah, and the flag level, this is the regular flag level, and then this is the origin, and this is yeah destination. From the origin to destination, the aircraft will pass the checkpoint or report point. Yeah, PKU is PKU, yeah, PKU, JATAM, PLB, yeah. And then this is the departure time and the yeah the departure time and the destination estimate time the flight will be until to destination. And yeah, in some case the flight will feel the turbulence and the flight will request to descend, yeah, like here. From the flag level 370, they request descent to flag level 350. Yeah, the location is here, 86 nautical mile from the PKU. Yeah, at the 805 UTC due to turbulence. So we can get this information. And then, yeah, I try to plot the information here. The information from the airstrip here, and I use the IDSB too. Yeah, to correct the information from the IDSB. The IDSB is the one of the sensor that can transmit the location and the position of the airplane. So it's very accurate. So I will so I use it for the verification of the ADS-B. And yeah, another source is I use a report from the Komite Nasional Keselamatan Transportasi, yeah, or NTSB, National Transport Safety Board, yeah. From the report, yeah, we can get the first is about the incident and accident by flag pace. Yeah, first about the takeoff, climbing, cruising, descending, holding, landing. Yeah, there are many incident and accident on the landing phase. So yeah, from here, we must be careful about from the statistic. Yeah, and then what is the weather related with the flag pace? From here there are some weather related with the flag pace. First is a thunderstorm rain and the rain itself and drizzle, turbulence and mist. Yeah, turbulence is the weather related with the flag pace on the cruising and on the descending. Yeah, from the NTSB data, I get the there are three turbulence happen, aviation turbulence that on the heavy intensity. The first in 4 May, the second in 6 May, and the third about 24 October. Yeah, the first happened to the Etihad Airways. There are the impact is not only to about the crew, but also the airplane. The route from the Abu Dhabi to Soekarno-Hatta, location over the Bangka Island. And the second is Hong Kong Airlines over South Kalimantan. It's a flag pace of the cruising, and there are impact to crew and airplane. And the Batik Air. The Batik Air over Sumatra, North Sumatra, from the Soekarno-Hatta to Kuala Namu, the impact crew and airplane itself. Yeah, This is the impact of the efficient turbulence. This is the force that happened to Etihad Airways. Yeah, we can see. There are a cabin in the cabin. Broken here, and the lavatory. I'm sorry. This is the flight attendant cabin. There are many food, and then the oxygen mask. Yeah, they are broken. And then, this is the same with the Hong Kong airline. The impact is related with the body of the airplane, and this is the same to the Batik Air. In here, where is the location? The location of the turbulence from the NTSG report data. The force is on 4 May in here in the left picture. The white dot is the another flight, but in different time. So we can see some of the flight is a different route. In different route, maybe the pilot will choose their route, and the turbulence happen here. And then on the 6 May, from the Bali to Hong Kong, they use this route. The white dot is the another route, and this is the same with the Batik Air, 24 October, from the Jakarta to Kuala Namu. The same, they are same different route. We will try to what is about the cloud analysis near the turbulence location. This is the for the 4 May. I try to use 60 band, but in this slide I just show you about the sum of band that we can see clearly a different between each band. We use band 9 and band 10. This is a water vapor band. The star red is the location of the turbulence. This is the 30 minute before turbulence. This is the time of the turbulence, and this is after turbulence. From the turbulence event, we can see that the location of the turbulence near the a small cloud here. Red color mean a low of the temperature, mean of the there are any cloud on the with the top, with the height of top. So we can see here that the location of the turbulence near of the cloud that have a top high top. And after that, the cloud is developed. From here we can see that any sum of the cloud. There are no height of cloud. And then this is the same, but with the band of the 12, we cannot see good of the cloud here. Not a clearly a cloud. So because each band have each characteristic. So from here, from the band 12, we can see there are cloud, no cloud, cloud, no cloud here before the event. But it's clear here, but they are not clear. This is the cloud analysis with the each band, and I try use the convective cloud, which we use the algorithm of the convective initiation here. At the location that happened turbulence here, there are green is the top of the cloud is around minus 45 until to 60. So there are any convective cloud here, and the cloud is developed. I try to validate the convective cloud. Use the observation on the ground. Use METAR information. And yeah, at the first, we can see there are the cloud the station here located here, and there are no convective cloud. Yeah, maybe. And then at the event of the turbulence, the observer say there are any convective cloud. Yeah, maybe this is a convective cloud, and this is a convective cloud. And then after the event, after the accident, the observer see about the convective cloud too. So the algorithm of the convective initiation is good to detect the convective cloud. So with the turbulence here, it's related with the convective. And then about the next turbulence event. Yeah, we use a band 5. It band 5 near infrared. So they use fusible to infrared, near infrared. So they cannot detect the cloud because the time of the turbulence happened on the midnight. Yeah, so we cannot use a fusible band, near infrared band. So we can use this here, water vapor band. Yeah, we can see the yellow star is the location of the turbulence. Yeah, this is the location the turbulence happened. So we can see that the location of the turbulence is they have a many humidity. It's very humid, yeah, very humid. So we can say that there are many cloud there. Many cloud there. I'm sorry. So before the accident, yeah, until the accident and after, there are many cloud over the location. So at this time, the plane is over the cloud, yeah, with the convective cloud. Yeah, I verify with another band. Yeah, we can see there are low of the degree of the cloud here and here. This is the maybe it's the same. Yeah, I try to use convective initiation too, to detect the location of the turbulence. Is related with the convective or not? So yeah, we can see that the location is in of the cloud of in convective cloud. Yeah, I try to validate the convective initiation with the ground observation. From the ground observation, they say there are vicinity turbulence, vicinity thunderstorm. Yeah, from the vicinity thunderstorm, then this is vicinity thunderstorm too. Vicinity thunderstorm, vicinity related to the there are any thunderstorm near the aerodrome, and the thunderstorm is storm that with the thunder produced by a cumulonimbus cloud. So in this turbulence, it's very related because in convective cloud. And for the third of the turbulence, this is the time of the turbulence. We can see that the turbulence, is near to with the cloud, but not in cloud. It is different between the previous accident. Yeah, but we can see that before turbulence, at the turbulence and after turbulence here. Yeah, we can see there are any convective here near the turbulence. Yeah, I try with the convective initiation too. And I try to validate the cloud. And we can see that the convective initiation is good, yeah, because the ground say there are any convective cloud, yeah, it's right, yeah, and the location, yeah. So the event, three of the event related with the convective cloud. So convective cloud on Indonesia is very important to make turbulence related with the aviation. Yeah, maybe it's for me. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Muhammad Arif Munandar, for very interesting presentations. So now we are going to the next speaker or instructors, Ms. Ruisong. This is your time to presentation.
Okay, now I will begin.
You can share your screen.
Yes, now I'm doing it.
Yes, you have about 45 minutes to deliver your presentation.
Okay, can you see the slide?
Yes, clearly, Miss.
Okay, now I will begin the presentation. Hello, everyone. My name is Suri from Chiba University. And today, my topic is the atmospheric anomalies preceding the large shallow focus earthquake. It is the seismic atmospheric effect detected from the China Seismo-Electromagnetic Satellite. This is the content of today's presentation. It has mainly four parts. The first one is the research background. In this part, I will introduce the information about the ionosphere and then the research progress of the pre-earthquake ionospheric anomalies research. And the last one in section one, I will introduce the China Seismo-Electromagnetic Satellite. And in section two, I will introduce our research results related to the ionospheric anomalies before for Indonesia earthquake happened in 2018. And also in detail, I will introduce data sources, research results, and some statistic analysis. And then in section three, it is the anomalies, also ionospheric anomalies before the Jamaica earthquake. This earthquake occurred in 2020. Also, I will introduce our research results detected by the China Seismo-Electromagnetic Satellite. And the last part is conclusion. So now first, it is the first part, part one, research background. Firstly, I will introduce you some information about the ionosphere, because I think all of you may be not familiar with the ionosphere, so I will introduce it detailedly. The ionosphere is at the altitude about 16 kilometers to 500 kilometers above the Earth's surface. In the ionosphere, it is filled with the neutral atmosphere and the plasma. The ionosphere is the connection between the deep crust, the Earth's surface, the middle atmosphere. This is the ionosphere and the magnetosphere and the interplanetary space. Shown as the red subplot in finger one, this finger shows the detailed structure of the ionosphere. From this finger, we can see as for the daytime ionosphere, it can be divided into D region, F layer, E layer, F layer, and in addition, F layer can be divided into F1 layer and F2 layer respectively. However, during the next time, in the ionosphere, the D region and the F1 layer will disappear. Only there is only E layer and F layer in the nighttime ionosphere. And then as for the research progress of the seismic ionospheric effect, this kind of study is firstly began in 1916 when two American scientists first studied the Alaska M8.5 earthquake happened in 2016-4. They first detected that several days before this earthquake, there is obvious positive disturbance around the epicenter. And since then, many researchers engaged in this field. At the present, as for the observation method at the present, it can be divided into two kinds. The first kind is the ground-based observation method, and the second one is the space-based observation method. As for the ground-based observation method, in our research, we always use the F2 layer critical frequency. We call it FOF2 for short, and the ES layer critical frequency, we call it FOES for short, and the mostly adopted parameter is the total electron content, we call it TEC for short. All these kinds of parameters can be detected by the ground-based receivers. And as for the space-based observation method, in this kind of method, the ULF, VLF, ELF emissions and the plasma temperature, electron or ionosphere, or the ion density is generally used for this method. And for example, finger two shows the disturbance of the plasma density and the temperature 6 days before and after the Wenchuan earthquake happened in May 12 in the year 2008. This kind of research is detected by the space-based observation method by the Demeter satellite, and we can see there is this. The red star is the epicenter of the Wenchuan earthquake. And we can see there is an obvious disturbance like the blue color. The blue color marks the disturbance. There is very obvious disturbance 6 days before and after the Wenchuan earthquake. So at the present, based on the promising ionospheric seismic ionospheric effect. And the China government launched the China Seismo-Electromagnetic Satellite, we call it CSES for short, on the day February 2 in 2008. It is a satellite for both the earthquake observation and the geophysical field research. This is the photo of the CIS satellite. And here I list the main orbit parameter of this satellite. We can see from table one, as for the orbit altitude, it is about 500 kilometers. It is a low orbit satellite. And the inclination angle is about 100 degree, and the local time of ascending node and the local time of descending node is 2 a.m. and 2 p.m. respectively. This is the local time. And as for the revisiting period of this satellite, it is 5 days. It means at one specific location. Every 5 days, the CIS satellite with will pass through the same location. And here, it is the sub-satellite footprint tracks in 5 days. And then the second part is the ionospheric anomalies before for Indonesia earthquake. First, let us see the earthquake information. After we check the earthquake catalog, there are four consecutive shallow focus earthquakes in a short period in Lombok, Indonesia during July to August in the year 2008. In table two, I list the detailed information about the four earthquakes in Lombok, Indonesia. This is the earthquake type, and this is the latitude and the longitude of the epicenter. And this is the depth of the earthquake. We can see all the earthquake is the shallow focus earthquake because the depth is shallow. And this is the magnitude of the earthquake. And from finger four, I marked the epicenter of the four earthquakes. This and the blue color is the first earthquake. Yellow color is the second earthquake. Red color is the third one, and the green color is the last one. We can see the epicenter is very near. And as for the data sources we used in this study, first, as I introduced previously, it is the ionospheric electron density. We call it NE for short. For short, electron density and detected from the CSES satellite. And then and the same NE value from the International Reference Ionospheric Model, the version of 2016, we call it IRI model for short, is also adopted in our study. And the global ionosphere map, GIM, provided from CODE is also adopted in our study. And first, let us see finger five. This finger shows the launch and the flight status of this satellite. We can see there is a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, a total of nine payloads on board this satellite. And in our study, we use the NE values on board the Long Mirror Probe, LAP. In our study, the NE value is detected by the LAP on board the CIS satellite. Here, now I will show you our research results. We detect the NE disturbance by this formula. It is the percent disturbance of NE. NE OBS is the observation date, and NE media is the media values 2 days, 20 days, 20 days before the observed day. And after we calculate, we found there are four obvious positive disturbance occurred. This is 1 day before the first earthquake. Finger 6B exhibits the positive anomalies. Detected, this is 6 days before the second earthquake. And finger C, this is the positive anomalies detected on August 7 in 2008. This is 2 days before the third earthquake. And the last finger, in finger D, this is the positive anomalies detected in August 14. This is 5 days before the last earthquake. We can see all in our study, all these four disturbances just happened before the four earthquakes. This is 1 day before, this is 5 days before, this is 2 days before, and this is 5 days before each earthquake. And generally speaking, in the pre-earthquake ionospheric research, we must check the space weather, because also this kind of disturbance will be probably influenced by the solar activity. So after we check the space weather on these 4 days here, this one, and this one, we can see the space weather during all these abnormal days is very calm. This is DST. DST is, boost the DST is larger than minus 30, means there is no geostorm happened. And KP is, all the KP during the 4 day is smaller than 3, also means that the solar activity is very calm. So we can exclude that this kind of disturbance caused by the solar activity. Because just now I talked about that the revolving period of the CIS satellite is 5 days. So we did a further study based on the revolving orbit. This is the yellow line is the abnormal orbit detected on July 31. And we compared this abnormal orbit with his four revolving orbits 5 and 10 days before and after this abnormal orbit. We can see only the abnormal orbit detected the largest NE values. This is on the day July 31. This is for the second earthquake. It is 6 days before the second earthquake. There is very obvious NE increase. And then as for the abnormal orbit detected on August 7, this is correspond to the third earthquake. This is 2 days before the third earthquake. We can see as for the abnormal orbit, like the yellow color. Also, here there is a remarkable increase of the NE values. And also we can see the yellow star and the red star marks the epicenter. Both the abnormal disturbance occurred in the north side of the epicenter. And then we also did some study about the electron temperature for the same revolving orbit. But we found that as for the electron temperature, there is no obvious difference compared with the electron density NE. A further study is conducted based on the GMTC dataset, also by the same equation. TCV is a great TC date provided by code, and the TC medium is the medium value 2 weeks before the observed date. And we can say here is an example of the last earthquake. This is the epicenter marked by the green star. And we can see there, as for the TEC observation, there is also obvious positive disturbance. In the color bar, the red color means the positive percent disturbance, and the blue one means the negative percent disturbance. And from our results, we can see there is very obvious positive percent disturbance in the north side of the epicenter. Here, this one, and this one. It lasts for more than 6 hours. And till 10 UT, the abnormal disappear. Both the TEC dataset and the NE values detected by the CIS satellite detected the similar disturbance before the full Indonesia earthquake in 2018. We did a statistic analysis in the around the Lombok, Indonesia area. After we checked the earthquake catalog, there is a total of 35 earthquake cases occurred during 2007 to 2017 in the condition of magnitude larger than 5.8, and the earthquake depth is a shallow focused earthquake. Depth is smaller than 15 kilometers is adopted. And the statistic analysis concerning the GMTC dataset associated with the seismic event is performed by the SEE method. In the statistic analysis, we only could use the GMTC dataset because the CIS satellite is a new launched satellite. So during these 10 years, there is no data detected by the CIS satellite. So as for the statistic analysis, we only use the GMTC dataset. And here in finger 10, this finger marks the distribution of the this 35 earthquake cases for the statistic analysis in Indonesia. And this finger shows the statistic analysis results. We can see from finger 11A, this finger shows the total anomalies. Total anomalies include both the positive and the negative anomalies. We can see the y-axis is the count of TEC disturbance, and zero means the earthquake day. We can see from 1 day and 7 days before the other 35 in earthquake around Lombok, Indonesia. The count of anomaly is much larger than the other days. 1 week before. Minus means 1 day before. Minus one means 1 day before the earthquake, and one means 1 day after the earthquake. So we can see there is an obvious increasement of the disturbance count 1 week before all the earthquakes. We also plot the positive anomaly and the negative anomaly respectively. And after compare with finger B, and finger C, we can see the positive anomalies before the Lombok, the earthquakes occurred in the Lombok area is much larger than the negative anomalies. This is a statistic analysis in our study. And then part three is anomalies before the Jamaica earthquake. First, also the similar as section two, I will introduce about the earthquake information first. Shown as this finger marks the epicenter of the Jamaica earthquake. This earthquake has a magnitude of 7.7. It is occurred in 2020 in January 28 in 2020, and this is the earthquake type. This is the specific epicenter, and also this is the shallow focus earthquake because the depth is shallow. This weather will probably influence the ionospheric disturbance. So first, we check the space weather index. Also, the same index is adopted as the Lombok earthquake, DST, KP, and F10.7. We can see all the we can see this is a black dotted line is the earthquake day, and we can see 1 week before the earthquake, the space weather is very keen. So in this study, we can exclude that the disturbance 1 week before the earthquake is influenced by the solar activity. This finger shows the disturbed TC dataset. The TC dataset is the GMTC provided by code. And from this finger, we can see the red star is the epicenter here. We can see there is also positive disturbance, TC disturbance, mainly occurred in the north side of the epicenter before the Jamaica earthquake. we can see as for the detected time, the local time is UT minus 5. So we can see the disturbance is detected in the night time of Jamaica. And it lasts for about 6 hours, the same as the Lombok earthquake. And also during the daytime, we found there are some not very obvious positive disturbance in the south of the epicenter. And also it compared with the positive one, the lasting time is only 3 hours, but the positive disturbance is 6 hours. And also, we found that 6 days before the Jamaica earthquake, there is also this kind of disturbance in the south side of the epicenter. This one, and this one. And also lasts for about 6 hours. As for this day, 6 days before the earthquake, there is no this kind of disturbance during the daytime, only the nighttime, there is positive disturbance. And also we use the NE detected from the CIS satellite and the Langmuir, from the Langmuir probe on board the CIS satellite for a further study. From the earthquake information, the earthquake time is January 28. And we can see detected from the the satellite, there is very obvious positive NE disturbance occurred on January 21 and January 22. This is 7 days and 6 days before the Jamaica earthquake. Here, I marked the epicenter as a black star. And it is very clearly that in the north side of the earthquake, the NE values detected by the Langmuir probe on board the CIS satellite also detected positive NE anomalies 6 days and 7 days before the earthquake. And to make our result more accurate, we compared this period with the other two periods respectively. For example, this finger shows the same value, NE values by Langmuir probe from CIS satellite on the day January 13 to January 17. This is 15 days before to 11 days before the earthquake. We also from here we can see in the north side of the epicenter there is no this kind of positive disturbance during these days. Similarly, from this finger shows the similar result, NE value disturbance, NE value variation during January 27 to January 31. This is 1 day before and 3 days after the Jamaica earthquake. Similarly, we can see there is no this kind of disturbance in the north side of the epicenter, the same as this one. So most possibly, this kind of disturbance is related to the Jamaica earthquake. And this is the this other orbit is the ascending orbit. Ascending orbit correspond to the local time of 2 a.m. This is the nighttime disturbance. And also, as for the Jamaica earthquake, we did a further study related to the revolving orbit track. From here, there is a very obvious disturbance by the ascending orbit 10914. And so here we compared 10914 with this orbit with its two previous and two previous and two after a revolving orbit respectively. As for the black line, this is the abnormal orbit, and the red star is the epicenter. We can see also the abnormal orbit exhibits the largest value than the four revolving orbits. And also as for the temperature, there is no this kind of obvious disturbance, the same as the Lombok earthquake. Then as for the other abnormal orbit, 10929 detected on January 21. We also compared the NE value with the similar value observed by its four revolving orbits. Similar, we can see from the black line, this is the abnormal orbit. Also, this orbit exhibits the largest value at this area than the other four relating orbit. And the last part is the conclusion. First, by calculating the percent disturbance of electron density from CIS satellite around the four earthquakes in Lombok, Indonesia, And there are four corresponding anomalies in the north and northeast within 2,000 kilometers from each epicenter. A further study is conducted on the statistic analysis using the SEA method. And based on a total of 16.5 seismic events in this area, Lombok, Indonesia, and the statistic analysis indicates the high correlation between earthquake and the pre-earthquake atmospheric anomalies. As for the Jamaica M7.7 earthquake, from the GMTC, there is positive anomalies 8 days and 5 days in the local night time. And as for the NE detected by this satellite, all the NE disturbance is detected in the local night time and 6 days and 5 days before, 6 days and 7 days before the Jamaica earthquake. Okay, that's all. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Risong, for very interesting presentation too. Now we are going to the question and answer sessions. So to all participants, if you have any questions to the speakers, you can write down to the chat box or you can raise your hand and ask directly. Here, our speaker is Mr. Muhammad Arif Munandar, PhD student from Chiba University, Japan, and working in the MKG. And the next speaker is Ms. Rui Song from PhD student in Chiba University, Japan. There's a question to Mr. Arif Munandar. I will read. You are talking about the plane, how the relations with the turbulence and the signal maybe from the airport. So it means that the information about the weather and the cold conditions to the plane sent from your department in the MPG, or maybe how the process is going, how this information is going. I think the question is like this.
Okay, thank you very much, Ms. Harmita. Yes. I'm sorry, but the question is related with the information from the airplane to BMKG office.
Yes.
Yeah, the pilot communicate directly to the air traffic control with the VHF frequency. Only to the air traffic control. So all of the activity air traffic control must know. The air traffic control write about the information related with the weather or related with the another event from the day before takeoff until landing at the destination. So BMKG office get the information from the air traffic control. There are no connection because it's only between pilot and air traffic control. Okay, maybe this is the answer. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for the answer. So in the BMKG, you will maybe, I don't know about it, but there are information about the condition of the weather.
The information about the weather from the BMKG get from the office station. Because on the ground, we get the information from the office station. We have more than 100 station on Indonesia to inform the weather information to the airplane, and we use the satellite or radar information, radar data to get the information, and then the weather model to analyze or to forecast the weather data.
Okay. I'm curious about when I'm going to the airport, maybe have a flight. I always check about the weather, but sometimes I don't know where I will check. But maybe if I will fly from Makassar, maybe to Jakarta, where I will get the right informations about the weather situations, maybe in the BMKG apps, or I think it's different between the weather condition when we are flight and the weather condition like every day. So
yeah.
Where we will get the information?
Yeah, it's very different between we divide in Deputy of Meteorology, we divide into three information: public information, and then aviation information, and then maritime information. Yeah, if you use an airplane and you will know about the weather condition, yeah, you can open the website aviation.bmkg.go.id. And maybe first you can choose about the observation, yeah. Because in aviation we have code. Maybe you can study about the specific code, because for the example, from the Cengkareng Soekarno Hatta to Juanda, yeah. Soekarno Hatta there are three letter or four letter code. The three letter is C G K, and the four letter is W I I I. Yeah, and same with the Juanda. Juanda, the three letter is S B A, and the four letter is W R R R. And you first you know about the code of the each of the airport. And you can looking for the weather situation there. Like if you want to use airplane from the Jakarta to Juanda, Surabaya, you want to know how about the weather on Juanda. Yeah, you can open the aviation BMKG website and go to the observation menu, and you can choose the meter. Yeah, and you can write Y A R R. And you can enter, choose. You can, oh, the weather in Juanda is good. The wind, the visibility, the cloud, the weather, oh, it's good. So you can, you can feel safety first, because on the destination is a good condition. And the second, you can, you know about the how about in the journey? Is there are any cloud or no? Yeah. So you can open the satellite. Yeah, you can open the from the website too. Oh, there are any cloud, but not only a thick cloud, not a convective cloud like a cumulonimbus. So you can imagine. Maybe the first is you know about the route from the Soekarno Hatta to Juanda. Yeah, and you can imagine from the weather satellite. The route is not across the cloud, so it's maybe it's a safe for your journey. And then on the airplane itself, there are any radar weather. Yeah, radar weather in airplane used by the pilot to detect the cumulonimbus or to detect the cloud. Yeah, you can feel the difference between some of the airline. Yeah, but almost of the pilot use the radar to avoid, and they can they choose the best route for the passenger, because if the passenger feel always turbulent, maybe they not feel safety. Yeah. Yeah, maybe you can choose, you can feel the difference between some of airline. Yeah, sometimes if I use this airline, I feel safe. But if I use this airline, I feel yeah, something like that. It's maybe according about the pilot, something like that. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for the answer. Very interesting, Mr. Muhammad Arif Nader. And now we have another question. I think this question to Ms. Ruiz Song. In the seismology, we call the anomaly with precursor. So how we can determine that the anomaly is a signal that equation will occur before or after equation?
Okay, at the present. At the present, to focus whether earthquake is happen or not is very difficult because in our case, we start focus on the ionospheric anomaly is related to earthquake because the lithosphere, atmosphere, ionosphere coupling mechanism is very complicated. So at the present, we could only summary the basic role of the pre-earthquake anomalies and did some further study of the mechanism related to the coupling mechanism. In our study, we only did the research after one large earthquake. And I think for all the geophysics study researchers, how to focus earthquake accurately is very difficult. So at the present, most of our research is only focused on the post-earthquake anomaly analysis and to find the basic rules about the anomalies. So I think how to focus earthquake accurately is still needs much more study and much more earthquake cases to summarize the basic rules and we need to further study the mechanism and then we can focus earthquake accurately. But at the present, it is difficult.
Okay, thank you for the answer. And then the next question to Mr. Arif Munander. It is very interesting topics. Is it possible if the first hours the weather is good, but after the flight it becomes bad?
Yeah. It's possible. As we know that Indonesia located in the tropical area, so the development of the cloud is very high. Yeah, like yeah, I try to observe the cloud 10 minutes until 30 minutes is very different cloud. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, because yeah, you know that in the tropic area is we have a higher radiative than another region, and then we get the mass from the Pacific Ocean, so is very affected our region. So the information is weather information is very useful because some airlines use a specific categories like you if you use like Garuda is very different between a Lion Air group, yeah. So they have a specific like if the like a Garuda is used, yeah. If the condition is bad, they don't want to land. Yeah, they wait until the good weather. Yeah, because this is a real condition, and yeah, because I have an experience like the Sriwijaya. They want to land to Kendari from the Makassar, but the weather is bad. They wait until the good weather, and the officer sit with me and they write about the weather condition. If good, they call the pilot. It's a good condition, pilot. You can take off and go to the Kendari. So it's very possible. So we always observe the weather 24 hour, and with the high automatic equipment in every airport. Maybe I like it. Thank you.
Okay, so the condition of the weather is change every time.
Yeah, change every time.
Okay, thank you for the answer. Is there any question from participants again? Usually our participant is more than 100, but we have some report that some student in ITB cannot join because they have the same class in the same time.
Yeah, no problem. And yeah. This is yeah.
Okay. If there is no question again, Pak Wahyudi, can you hear me? Or maybe question from Pak Indra. Do you have any or something to say? If there is no question again, we are going to the photo sessions. How about the materials, Pak Arif Munandar and Ms. Ruisong? Can you share with the participants?
Yeah,
maybe
yeah.
Through Pak Wahyudi.
Okay, I will send to
yes.
Mr. Dr.
Okay.
Wahyudi.
Okay, thank you. Pak Wahyudi, do you have something to say before we're going to the photo sessions?
Yes. On behalf of our Department of Geophysical Engineering, we thank you very much for the talks of Pak Arif Munandar and Ms. Rui Song. Yeah, it's a valuable lecture for us. Hopefully, we can meet together in next time. And thank you very much. Okay. Thank you.
You are welcome.
Thank you.
Dr. Wahyudi. Thank you. Sama-sama.
Thank
you. Senang bisa bertemu.
Yes. So to all participants, please turn on your camera. We are going to the photo sessions. Okay. If you are available, you can open your camera. So we will start from page 1, 1, 2, 3. The next page, 1, 2, 3. The next page, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Thank you to all participants. And thank you to Mr. Muhammad Arif Munandar and Ms. Ruisong for your very interesting talk. It's very informative to all of us. And we hope to see you again in the next room or in the next agenda. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
To all participants, don't forget to fill the attendance, please. And the next session is this night. The topic is fractures identification and characterization. The instructor is Dr. Alpen Rudiawan from Bandung Institute of Technology. So see you in the night at 7 p.m. Okay. Wahyudi, you can close the room. Thank
okay.
you.
Thank you very much. Now I stop the recording. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, and okay, and we.